Hello everyone, and I just wanted to say thank you all for watching my Samsung Galaxy S3 tutorial. All your comments are greatly appreciated, and sorry I don't have more tutorials for that phone, but that seems to be the one that was the hardest to figure out. But anyway, this tutorial is for the iPhone 4S, and again, it has to do with music. I believe the versions of the iPhone 4, 4S, and 5 are pretty similar as far as this goes, but this one is specifically for the 4S. Try it on the other phones and see if it works for you. First of all, I wanted to put my music into my phone, and in order to do that through the iPhone, you must have an iTunes account. So if you don't have one yet, create one and then import your songs. But if you already have an iTunes account, it only recognizes certain songs. And if you look, these are the songs that are in my external hard drive on my computer. Just some of them are showing now. And when they are in the iTunes library, they are actually designated by a little icon right here. You can see this one, for instance, is in the iTunes library. And you can see it has a music, a double music note symbol. To show me that it's already in my iTunes account. If you go to the one just above it, you see it has a single note. I don't know if those are 16th notes or 8th notes or what they are, but it's been a long time since I've taken music. Anyway, that one is actually a light blue in color. Depending upon the computer you have, it might be a different color, but for this case and purpose, the single note shows that it is not in my iTunes library. I want to put it in my iTunes library. iTunes did not recognize it because it's in the incorrect form to be transferred to the iTunes library. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you all how to get these songs into your iTunes library so you can put them on your phone, enjoy them anywhere you want to go, and it's pretty simple step. First of all, open up your music catalog. I have it in an external hard drive, like I said, so you can see right here music. It's actually on this file right here, my passport. Double click on that, I hit music, and bam, all my files come up. So wherever you have them stored on your computer, go there. Once you have that open, you need to open up your iTunes Store. Now, if you have an iPhone, you probably already know the minute you connect your phone to the computer, your iTunes Store automatically pops up, which I have here. If you look in the top right-hand corner over here, it shows iPhone, and that way you know that your iPhone has been connected. So what I need to do now is just show you the iPhone right there, so you know it's already connected to the iTunes Store. Now what I need to do is get those files into my iTunes account. I have a lot of songs in my iTunes library, as you can see by scrolling through. By the way, if you're in iTunes and you see these little symbols right here, so these block of symbols, that is actually what songs have been stored in the cloud. As you can see, not all my songs are stored in the cloud. These ones right here are, and as you can see, these couple above here are not stored in the cloud. Just a side note. Anyway, when you go to transfer your music into your iTunes account from your external hard drive on your computer, or if you have a flash drive, or just on your computer by itself, wherever you have your songs stored, this is how you do it. So you want to go into iTunes. There is a little icon at the very top of the screen. Can you see that right there? It took me a while to find this little icon right here. I couldn't quite figure it out, but then I found it. If you click on the little drop-down arrow, it'll say Add File to Library. You click on that, and bam, it's brought up already my songs that I wanted to add into the account. Once again, if you look here, you can see that these notes are the same as what I showed you before. This is in my iTunes library. This one is not in my iTunes library. So let's say I want to add it. I've already added this one. So for this tutorial purposes, I will hit this one. So now I want to add it. So I click on the song. You can either double click it or just click it once and hit open right here at the bottom. Click once open. It's going to give you a warning. And this warning states that one or more of your songs, oops, sorry about the jitteriness, one or more of the songs you are adding to iTunes, including O One Angel of the Morning, are in WMA format. iTunes will automatically convert them to an AAC format so they can be added to your iTunes library. Okay, well, I want to do that because I want it in my iTunes library. And if I hit this little button right here, convert, you can see at the very top, it's converting it, and it takes a few seconds to convert it. Once it's converted, the little Apple icon will appear. That means that it has been downloaded, and that song, I have them in alphabetical order by the artist. And if you go right down here, this is an oldie, but if you go right down here to Juice Newton, and if you look here, bam, here is Angel of the Morning. Okay? So it's pretty quick and easy. Just open up your external hard drive where you have the songs stored. If iTunes did not convert all your songs in the beginning, then you can do it this way. And it works pretty simple. For all intents and purposes, let's say we want to go ahead and, you know, you can, the nice thing about this is you can actually add more songs if you want. If you hit, you click on the next song in the list, hold down the control key on your keyboard and just keep clicking the songs. I'll just do 4 for this one. You can highlight every song that is not already on your iTunes library. Hit open. It'll give you that warning again. I want to convert. And if you see here at the top, it's starting to convert. Born on the Bayou. And then it will boom California Dreamin'. And so on and so forth. It will continue to just convert everything until you're completely done. I had 4 songs. So it's converting 4 songs and then it's done and they're all in your iTunes library. Thank you very much for watching. Comments, questions, let me know. Have a good day. Bye.